Now, while in build mode, you can modify objects that are on the display, as I mentioned earlier. Let me go ahead and launch this display. I'll switch over to build mode. And as you can see, when you click on something in build mode, you get these resizing handles. And this is what you would use to do the typical resizing that you would do, you know, when working with objects. As I mentioned, you can also position things in build mode. Here's some objects that can be positioned. I'll undo that. And there's all kinds of subtleties I want to go over about build mode. For example, I'm in build mode and I'm going to create this arc. Okay. That's my arc. I can select that and you see these, we have the normal resizing handles that you see. It allows me to resize this. But in addition, you see these little endpoint handles. You can use that to actually extend the arc. And that's something that's not readily intuitive. Likewise, one of the things you can do in build mode when you're working with different objects, like for example this polygon here, is you can modify individual endpoints. So let me create a hexagon here. As you can see, we have the resizing handles as you'd expect in build mode, but then we also have these point by point handles here as well. So I can go here and modify this as needed. Now there's not much purpose in going through all of these different things. I would suggest, you know, if you're working with any kind of an object-oriented editor before, you'll notice pretty much the same types of things you can do in an edit mode with an object-oriented editor, graphic editor, you'll be able to do with Process Book. It is object-oriented.